Hey everybody, my name is Prez and welcome to episode 6 or no, this is 7 I believe. Is this 7? This is 7 of City Skylines Falcon Falls. So, today I have something planned. So we've got to fill this space right here cuz this is sort of I want to connect this area. So over here last episode we built this American suburban complex, which looks awesome. Let me actually turn off my sun shafts real quick, because it's, like, lowering my FPS a ton. Actually, I might... I'm gonna turn it off. There we go, that's much better. We're almost breaking 60. No, we're good. FPS is fine, so... today we're gonna be working on a sewage treatment plant right here, and some neighborhoods around here. I want to fill this whole area in this episode, and I think we're going to be able to do that. So, I've got a bunch of assets for this. So, I've got this, and then a ton of things over here. We're going to integrate all of them. So, first off, I want to place some of these. I've already made a little road system around here, and I think that'll work. I want to possibly connect this quickly. Let's turn prop anarchy off. Let's do this. Let's actually move this over here just so we can connect this. Actually, no. We're going to connect it right here. Let's try to do this. Are we going to be able to connect this at all? Let's see. Maybe we can get this to work. Okay, I'm not very happy with that. I need this to be perfect. So, I might just connect this right over here. Yeah, this is definitely better. And we can do that. Okay, so now we've got this road connected right in here. That sort of goes through the sewage treatment plant here, so. Anyway, let's see. I'm not sure if I want to continue these because I don't want too many. I'm not gonna show you a ton of this. It's mostly gonna be a time-lapse episode, because we've got a lot to do. But I just wanted to do a little bit on camera to start things off. I don't know what your feedback was on the last episode with the on-camera stuff, because this is actually, I'm recording this 2 weeks before you're seeing it, most likely, so. Yeah, it's gonna be a while until you see this. Let's actually, I'll move it right here. So, exit the menu. Okay, good. I don't know why that took me so long. So, we're gonna place one of, okay, why, okay, my game is annoyed. Okay, so, there we go. That works, and then I'd like to, we can turn simulation off here, so let's do that, and then that, and then let's figure out, we'll leave that open quickly, let's just leave that open. We'll figure out what we want to put there. We've got a few buildings, over here that it can be, like, this is the grid and screen facility. I don't know which order I'm supposed to put these in or anything. I'm just putting them down. Let's do this. That works for me. And maybe this should go. I think this should go further over here. This small water pumping station, I think I want to integrate a little bit somewhere over here. Maybe it could work off of this building. That looks pretty good. I'm not gonna lie. I'm fine with that. So now we have a water pumping station. Yeah, this is gonna be a sort of a smaller builds a smaller sewage treatment plant than you'd a bigger one would be. We're gonna do something with some of these assets over in the harbor or somewhere more industrial later on. This is just a smaller plant right here. Connect those, and I'd like to maybe Let's do angle 45. Okay, and then we can continue that out here. No, not like that. Okay. Maybe we can make this curve. I think that's our only option here. So let's place this like this, because I'd like the, Oh no, we gotta upgrade the road. There we go, the zoning's good now. Okay, so let's place that there. And like that. So, that looks okay. I want to try to still add some... Okay, this just... I thought this was gonna look... Okay, maybe... Will this work, or does it look weird not being parallel to the other stuff? Okay, I'm gonna leave that there and think about it. So... I want to add a few more things before I go here. Let's add this larger building right in here. We have to edit the zoning quickly, and we can place this here. We can actually no, not this. We need to place this here. Okay, this is better, I think. This is definitely better. So we have to upgrade the zoning right here, and move this, and move it back. Okay, so let's see how that looks. I think that looks good, I'm not gonna lie. So let's actually add some concrete over here, and we're gonna have to figure out what we're gonna do over here. Maybe we can have a little parking lot, actually. Let's look up parking in our search box mod and grab okay, so right now my computer might be a little bit loud, so right now my background, like my computer's been really loud while recording, and I'm pretty sure it's just because this is City Skylines, and I think it my computer does not like sort of an intensive game when it's modded and stuff. So I gotta figure that out, because since I'm not using I have a background music on right now, probably. I'm not sure, but I don't know. I gotta figure that out, because I don't like the background noise, that we've, oh, will this work? Okay, I'm happy with that. That could work for me, and I'm probably gonna place some cars in here, just so it looks filled up and stuff. I'll do that later on. So let's figure this out. So since this is over here, we could do some sort of greenery thing over here. Let's place a few trees quickly. Let's do some live oaks and some conifers. Put some more conifers here. This can be more open, and I'll probably do some sort of, I don't know, I'll figure that out. I'm gonna probably do the detailing on a time lapse, and I'm gonna start that in just a moment. I'm gonna end this segment here, and I'll see you guys in the time lapse. Hey everybody, I am back. So, we have, at this point, done a ton of detailing here in the sewage treatment plant. And, yeah, there's gonna be a lot of foliage placement in this episode, but I think it balances out well. I just finished cutting the actual time-lapse itself, which I think is really important. I've been trying to do that more, and I think it actually, it really helps the video, the flow of the video, and you just gotta do it right, and I think I'm getting used to that. So anyway, as you can see, I'm adding some ground decals here, and I added a ton of those in this build, and I think they look awesome. This was recorded about 2 weeks ago, so these were pretty new back then. I was just using a ton of them. I think they just make big concrete spaces look so much better. As you might have noticed, my mountain texture has changed. I am now using the mountain texture from the Mountain Sound map theme by Fresh Popcorn, and I changed the theme of my map, like, while loading it. I uninstalled Environment Changer because apparently you can change the theme of an existing map loading it anyway, which I didn't actually know. I don't know why I didn't know that, but I thought you needed Environment Changer, and that's the only reason I had it. But it was actually just bugging up the way that loading with a different map theme works. Yeah, it was just extremely buggy, and apparently that was the issue. And the mod I had to fix something was actually making it, worse. So anyway, yeah, it's all good now, and I've got the Mountain Sounds mountain texture, and it looks a decent amount better up close. It doesn't look perfect, but you can take what you can get, guys. It's a lot better, in my opinion, up close, and I think it looks great from afar as well with all the cracks and stuff. I think it looks awesome. So also, I terraformed the area, and it's actually a little bit hilly now, and I think that that's really, really important, because if it's just flat and everything's flat, it's not good, and I needed to add hills. I needed to do that. I've actually already recorded the next episode as I am talking right now, and we expanded it a ton, so that's gonna be awesome. That should be out in a week for you guys or so. I added a bunch of hills in that episode as well. Adding hills is extremely important, because if you have a map that's extremely flat throughout a huge area, you gotta add hills, otherwise it just looks a little bit, I mean, at least for, if there are mountains around and it's just flatlands below the mountains and no hills at all, it just doesn't make sense. So I decided that adding some hills would be nice. Also, a highly requested thing, the asset list. So I have created an asset list, actually, at the time of recording this. It is not done. I am lazy, and it's a very tedious process, except it won't take forever, but it's really annoying because you have to click each asset one by one in the list of assets to add to the list. And if you stop for a second, Steam reloads the page because it applies that progress immediately. So if you stop for a second, you have to scroll all the way back down, and you waste like 5 seconds. So you have to do it just one after another, and then it won't automatically reload, and it's really annoying. Anyway, you guys don't care, you're probably not making asset collections, but if you do, it's annoying, beware. I think it's worth it though. You guys are gonna have all of the assets that I use, and if I ever release this as a save game later on in the future, I'll have the asset collection done already. And yeah, I actually did this because my brother wants to start playing the game again, so I wanted to give him my asset collection, and I don't have it, and it would be impossible for me to do it any other way than make a Steam collection, so I figured I need to do it anyway, might as well do it. Also, I've tried to add a little bit of variety to the tracks I use in my videos. So I mean, the time-lapse music you're listening to right now is probably going to be the same throughout while I'm talking, and I'm probably going to change it once the actual time-lapse starts. I don't know, but just stuff like this, I think just soundtracks like this, I have gotten from audionautix.com, I believe. It's always in the description, all of my music, so you can check that out there. And I think this music is great. It's royalty free. It doesn't really matter for me because I don't monetize my videos the current moment. So I don't know. Overall, royalty free music is nice if you can find good royalty free music, and it's pretty much guaranteed to be hassle free. So that's why I try to use royalty free music. And anyway, so yeah, as you can see, this area, I added a little motel. This whole region is a little bit rural, so yeah, I'd say pretty rural as it transitions into that larger town by the golf course that we had built before. So I think it was pretty appropriate to add a motel there. And anyway, so you can see I used my little technique of removing the sidewalks on two-lane roads, and it's pretty much by using the surface painter and painting over the road, and painting the clip option in surface painter. And that clip option is actually really awesome because it so many possibilities. You could remove concrete from stuff. I think surface painter, in the beginning, I thought it was just going to be nice because it would allow people who used the brushes assets. It was like parks that were concrete brushes and stuff. And those added to the building limit and lagged your game more and whatever. So I don't think anybody really felt amazing using those. So I thought that was all it was going to do, but it's actually added a lot of crazy options when it comes to ground textures. Ground textures have really been revolutionized and really changed a ton over the past few months, to be honest. And yeah, I haven't really played this game for a ton of time. I've been playing since like November 2015, and only around like maybe April, May of this year, I started really doing a lot of detailing stuff. And yeah, so I haven't been around forever, but all I know is that Surface Painter has revolutionized ground texturing, because before I don't know, over the past few months overall, I think ground texturing has just changed a ton. So yeah, as you can see, we're actually adding this little area. It's like a barn, and then there's the church in the woods there. You might, if you look at Reddit, you might have seen that. I posted it like a week or two ago, so I think this area turns out great in the end. It's probably one of my favorite parts of our city so far, not quite city yet, so far, is this little area. I think it looks amazing. So yeah, as you might have noticed here, I am actually using the puddle ground decal a little bit, and I'm using it just in the woods, like, just to texture the ground. And I think that's really cool, and I thought it would just be used in parking lots and stuff, but using it, like, in the woods just to make a little pond of some sort, I think this little ground texture pack is awesome. So I have a little bit of time I need to fill here, or I don't need to, I could just leave the music going, but yeah, I'm going to fill this time because I have something else to talk about. So what I want to talk about is the format of these videos. So in the last video, I pretty much did a lot of live gameplay and a lot of cuts, and I think that did not turn out great. So yeah, I think in the end, it just made the video so much worse, and overall, just not having any time-lapse footage or anything. I don't think that video was amazing, and I think it was good enough, but that's not enough for me at this point. I want these videos to be just decent enough, so because I'm spending like a decent amount of time on these videos, maybe 4 hours editing in total or something like that. Maybe 4 hours editing and recording the audio for the time lapses and stuff. And these time lapses in these videos, the footage is it's a lot of footage. This time lapse footage is, on average, I'd say like 4 hours an episode. So yeah, it's a lot of footage sped up 800%. So yeah, anyway, I'm gonna stick to the format that this video is. I think this video is one of my best videos, and I think this video ended up turning out great. Just editing it right now, I think it's a lot better than the last video. So anyway, I'm going to hop into live gameplay here just to look around at what we just built. I'll see you guys there. Hey everybody, I am back. So here is the finished sewage treatment plant. So we also have these surrounding areas filled in, like around here. And over here, we're in just a little town. So I'm gonna go through everything. So we've got this little thing. This is called a parking zone 5x6 corner. It's actually really nice. I think it's cool. So you can look that up and get that if you'd like. Put a little merry-go-round in there, because why not? Might edit that in the future. Nothing's final, so. And here's motel. I think this looks awesome. I think the colors work really well together, so I think that looks nice. And then moving forward, I love this. Look at this. I think that's great. Just a little RV over there with... I don't know what this is for, but why not? And then I have just foliage on the sides here, and these roads are sidewalkless, which I think is awesome. So anyway, moving forward here, we've got this is called Farm Park, if you'd like it. I think it looks awesome, and we sort of go into this little area with this church. I think this church looks really nice. I think this asset's like, I think this asset looks amazing. So yeah, we have a bunch of ground texturing in here, and I think it looks nice and overgrown, and I think it looks awesome. And here are the little ponds I made with the puddle decals. Also, we've got this little area in here, which is just sort of, like, it's just something. I'm not gonna include that as part of this video, but it's gonna, like, you know, we'll expand that a little bit and build around it in future episodes. Not for a few episodes, though, because we have other stuff to focus on. So, yeah, over here we've got a little road going over here, because why not? And then stuff like this, and then... Yeah, so I want to get the one-way train track spot, and there's a mod called Catenary Replacer, which I'm gonna download pretty soon, that just came out. And I think that mod's amazing, because you can actually replace these things right here, the catenaries, and you can actually remove them. You're going to be able to remove the wires as well soon, so it'll be like more train tracks, except you can't break your save games, which is amazing. I didn't start this save with more train tracks just because I knew I wouldn't want it in the future, because I knew Network Skins was coming out with a feature like that. I don't know. So, yeah. And we have this little area over here. I built this little stone wall around this guy's place, and there's a wagon wheel. Pretty cool prop, I'm not gonna lie. It's called the wagon wheel or something, I don't know. Some detailing over in here. Figured I'd add some foliage in there, because why not? I'm getting like 30 FPS right now. This isn't actually horrible considering. I'm not gonna lie. Okay, so here we are moving over here. I added one of those pipes that goes over, just because I thought, like, I mean, I don't know. Maybe why not? Just right over the parking. Why not? So that looks pretty good. Look at this view right here. Ignore the cinematic camera thing. I think that just looks amazing. Look at that view. Wow. Yeah, I think this is, like, this area right here is, like, my favorite part of the build, I'm not gonna lie. Which is probably a really bad thing, but I think it looks cool. So, then here we have over here, I actually have, a school bus prop placed right here. And just right next to this little thing in the road, it might look like maybe a bus stop of some sort, I don't know. So there's a school bus stopped right there. I should probably use the move it mod to move it further inwards. Amazing. Look at that. This mod's great. So, yeah, I think the ground textures really saved this little area, because without them it would have looked really bland. So then I added some of these fences over here. They're not perfect. I don't care. So, I think they just add some detail and look nice. So, that's pretty much it. I mean, we've got this little area, another little RV stopped right there. I actually removed the water pumping station you might have seen in the time lapse. I removed it because I thought it looked too bulky, and maybe this area is just like a water pool of some sort. I think it looks nice. Just keep it. Why not? I don't care. Yeah, that is pretty much it for this build, I believe. I think we've got a little bit more over here to look at. Like this road right here. Let's change the time of day. And just that view is really nice as well. I added these chevrons right here, and I think that just adds so much detail. I think it's awesome. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this build, and hopefully you did enjoy the video. If you did, be sure to leave a like. I think we got a lot done in this episode, and I think adding this hill right here, like, just, I think it looks so good. This little foothill right here. I think the train tracks going up this slope, I think they work really well, because there aren't too many turns overall that are sharp or anything. So I think that looks awesome. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Hopefully you all enjoyed the video. Enjoy these cinematics, and I'll see you next time.